Today in the news, we got a suspicious report about Navi and the Google I.O. What's up, guys? I'm Snows, and this is your boot sequence. Before we get into the I.O., let's talk about this AMD leak. A report from TweakTown's Anthony Garreffa says that the Radeon RX 3080 XT is being readied for E3 2019. This Navi 10 GPU should support 8GB of GDDR6 with 56 compute units at 190 watts TDP. All of this while aggressively priced at $330. This card is supposed to compete with the RTX 2070, which would literally cause a price war since the 2070 is currently at $499. After Computex, E3 would be a great place to showcase AMD's gaming performance both in the CPU and GPU market, and AMD is sure to be largely connected in this conference thanks to Google's Stadia platform using AMD hardware and if Xbox decides to tease their next-gen console. But at the same time, this info is hardly backed. Now don't get me wrong, I would love for this to happen, and it might, but this report is based on nothing. No sources, no insider info, which leads me to believe that it's a copypasta of AdoredTV's latest video on Navi. And on that video, Jim's latest update on the situation was as follows. 1. Navi can't match Vega 20 clocks, or at least they can, but the thermals and power are bad. 2. Disregard faith in Navi, the engineers can't wait to be done with it. And 3. 60 Navi compute units has trouble matching performance of 60 Vega 20 compute units. So TweakTown either seems to have forgotten to watch the whole video, or they have a secret source that we don't know about and isn't mentioned. If it's based on Jim's analyzing Navi video, I personally would disregard this report. Not that I don't think that Jim is credible. Far from it. He's very analytical and approaches these subjects with caution. It's just that this caution is often thrown out the window by a part of his audience and the info travels with the wrong intent. All right, let's get into the I.O. By the way, thanks for letting me know what you wanted me to cover. It's always nice to see you guys jump into the comments for some feedback. So we got the new Pixel 3a and 3a XL. They're both exactly what we thought they were. Cheaper versions of the Pixel 3s without a notch, but with a nice thick chin and forehead. They both get the flagship Pixel rear camera at a budget price, which is definitely one of the main reasons to buy this phone. The body is polycarbonate, aka plastic, and it features 4GB of RAM, 64GB of storage, and a Snapdragon 670. Great phone if you ask me, and it's available now. Then we have the Google Home line, which gets a rebrand after a year of release. The cute little home assistant display is now under the Google Nest brand and will be called the Nest Hub instead of the Google Home Hub. It also grew a camera on its face, which is a little bit of a concern since that privacy was kind of one of the main points when it came out last year. At least it will make good use of that camera with personalized results based on the facial recognition system. After that, we got a new Android Cube beta, which is available now with a dark theme and smart replies. I mean, I'm pretty new to Android, but isn't dark theme already there? Maybe it's just a feature of Oxygen OS, but with my OnePlus, pretty much everything gets dark once I flip the switch. The smart reply system will also be offered for third-party apps, allowing your phone to recommend replies in context to the message that you received. Neat. Oh, and Google Duplex is coming to the web. Basically, instead of calling businesses to book things, it will now be able to also do that directly on the internet. It's pretty neat, and I'm curious to see how it actually will work. You could technically book a car rental with it, but how will you know if you're getting the best price? Google I.O. was great, but honestly, there wasn't any major announcement like last year. I hope next year will be even bigger. I did spend quite a few hours listening to the Stadia's dev panel, but there was nothing new in terms of specs or info that caught my attention. Moving on, it looks like Scala is now more integrated than ever on Windows 10. If you update your app, you will now be able to summon Scala hands-free, similar to how you would with any other Amazon-compatible devices. Personally, I love that change since it is my primary digital assistant. It also now features compatibility with Pandora playback. On the other end, it looks like Cortana has not been forgotten either. It is still updated regularly and is now more business focused with a stronger conversational engine. Basically, it's catching up to all of its siblings. Any of you guys use Cortana on a regular basis? If you do, let me know how in the comments. I'd love to hear it. Anyways, guys, that concludes it for today. Hopefully you've enjoyed. As usual, you can click right here to see the latest video, right here to subscribe to the channel. It would be greatly appreciated. Stay frosty, and I'll see you guys on the next one. By the way, you might have noticed that there was like a light coming from the back that was like, it's sunset, just blazing on the back of my head. Anyways, take care.